What's good, YouTube? You know it is. Goody Beats, and back for another workout session, guys. As you can see, just got to Gold's Gym. Boom! And for any of you who are asking, yes, I did just sign up a new membership at Gold's Gym. So yes, I do have a membership at Gold's. I have a membership at THRC, and I used to have one at Anytime Fitness, but that's a long story. I don't have one anymore there. So I'm gonna just change things up, guys. I know you hear a lot of YouTubers say, hey, it's always good to change things up. I've been at THRC for a year. Nothing wrong with THRC. Just need a new change. Need a new change of scenery. And Gold's Gym is right across town, so. Hey, said what the heck, I'll try it out. Not sure how I'm gonna do it. I don't know if I'm gonna do a high quality edit or a walkthrough. I'm not sure. I guess you're soon gonna find out which one I picked. But yeah, we're gonna knock out a pretty intense workout, and then I will bring you along the way for a post workout meal because I know shit's gonna get real. Hashtag Beast Mode Jones. Anyways, guys, enough talking. Let's get inside. Let's get this workout done. So I hope you guys enjoyed that workout footage. About to go inside and have my post-workout meal. So I'm gonna show you what I'm having. All right, guys, so just got back to my office. As you can see, I got about 10 more minutes before my lunch is over, so I gotta scarf this down. Keeping it very simple, guys. I'm having one chicken leg with the skin and then 80-20 ground beef. That was, when it was uncooked, it was half a pound. I know it seems small right now, but I probably, as you can see, I burnt it. But keeping it very low carb, guys, keeping it very simple. You may or may not know this, guys, but I am incorporating cheat days into my keto cycle. Now, before y'all go crazy, guys, for all you keto people, I know you guys are going to about like just go crazy right now. You're not doing keto. No one does refeeds on keto days. No one does cheat days on keto. Guys, this is the way I do keto. I'm not saying it's the right way. I'm not saying it's the traditional way. I'm just saying this is the way I do keto, guys. I'm not getting ready for a show. I'm not trying to get as lean as I possibly can. I want to stay relatively lean. I want to somewhat keep the definition in the abs. Now, if I was getting ready for a show, guys, yes, then I would keep it 100% keto, most likely no cheat days. The reason why I do that cheat days is because I want to enjoy life. I want to enjoy time with my family, enjoy time with my friends, enjoy time with my wife. When we want to go out to eat, have a cheat meal, I'm able to do it. And then come Monday, get right back on my schedule of just very, very low carbs and doing just straight up keto. So that's the way I do it, guys. I'm gonna eat this food and then we'll see you on the next clip. All right, so just got done with the workout. Round two, hit shoulders, and then I did 20 minutes on the Stairmaster. Pretty good workout. I haven't done cardio in a long time, if I'm being honest. I don't know what it was. I just kind of just typically just got away from cardio, and it's very hard to get back into it, but I'm trying to implement it back into my workouts. I couldn't record the shoulder workout. It is a new gym, so I'm trying to find new friends, make new friends, find people who will record for me. My cousin does have a membership there, which is probably the only person I know there, and we don't always go at the same time. So anyways, gotta find new friends. Heading home right now, gonna have the post-workout meal, and then we will see you at the house. See, I checked the mail and of course bills, but just got a package in and I want to show you what I got. So let's set up the camera. Right, all right, so that lighting right there. Just kidding, guys. All right, so we got a package in the mail today, and as you can see, it is from Pump Chasers. Chris Jones representing Pump Chasers. All right, man, let's open up this bitch. All right, thank you. A little Chris Jones Pump Chasers thank you card. Boom, bam, 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 bam. So I had to buy one of Chris's shirts just because, you know, Chris is a really good friend of mine and I want to show support. And quite frankly, guys, this stuff, it looks pretty clean, to tell you the truth. The stuff he's coming out with is top notch. And I had to pick up this like money green shirt right here. Boom. Pretty nice. If anybody's wondering, this is a size medium. I will take pictures. Actually, I'll put it on. Ooh. Man. He wasn't lying when he says those sleeves hugging them guns. Where you at, Chris Jones? Where you at, dog? Just playing. Yeah, man. Feels pretty good, as you can see. Feels nice. Feels tight. Nice fit. Boom. Shout out, Chris Jones, Pump Chasers. All right, so now we're gonna eat. So let me show you what I'm having. All right, guys. It is shake time, shake time.
God damn it.
And as you can see right here, guys, we got two scoops of real food by Rich Piana. Now I'm only gonna have one scoop because this whole package right here is about 40 grams of carbs. Now, when you're on the keto diet, people ask, when should I take my carbs? Should I spread them throughout the day? Me personally, I recommend you have them immediately after your workout. Now I did work out twice today, but if I would just pick, we want to have it after the first workout or the second workout. Just so happened today, I want to have all my carbs on the second workout of the day. But it's really up to you. Or if you work out once a day, then have it after your first workout. You get my point. So, I'm gonna have one scoop. So, like I said, two scoops in here. I'm only gonna have one, which is about, okay. Boom, one scoop of real food. And then we are gonna do two scoops of my protein whey. Yes, I know, guys. I already know what you're gonna say. Logan, what are you doing? Where's your fat? You're supposed to be on keto. I know that, guys. But it's after a workout, and I really want the protein to hit my muscles immediately after the workout. So I know I said I don't believe in that. Whoa, 50. Damn it. So that's. All right, guys. So two scoops of protein, one scoop of real food. Now I know what you guys are thinking. Logan, what are you doing? You're supposed to be doing the keto diet. That's too much protein. Or it's not really too much protein, but it's too much protein in one I would wait, I would say one sitting, because I still got to get my fats, and most likely I'm going to get my fats from meats. So if I get my fats from meats, that means I'm going to go way over my protein. So if you're going to do that, if you're going to take protein shakes after your meal, then that means you have to get your fats from MTC oil, peanuts, avocados, things that are high in fat but not really high in protein. So that's the give or take, guys. So I do get that asked a lot, like, can I take protein shakes while I'm on the keto diet? Yes, you can, but you better get your fats from things that are not high in protein, because you'll go way over your protein, and we already know, we already established what happens when you go over your protein. Some of that converts to glucose, which is carbs, and that's like the whole point why you're doing the keto diet. You don't want that to happen. So anyways, I am going to get my fats most likely from peanuts or something. Oh yeah, guys, and another thing, if you haven't tried Real Food, now I have no sponsorship, no ties, no nothing to Rich Peanut's 5%, although I do have a 5% sticker on the back of my truck. That's just because I like Rich Peanut. But Real Food, man, I must say, I just had it for the first time like a couple weeks ago, and dude, it is absolutely so delicious, phenomenal, like 5 stars. I'm telling you, you have to go try it. I promise you, you will not be let down. Now, it doesn't, it's obviously, it's not like a protein shake. It's just clean carbs. It's just, I guess, for people like who are on the go and you can't cook your food, you can't meal prep, and you have Real Food, scoops of Real Food. You take that, it's pretty much the same thing, just like Real Food, but it is so freaking delicious, guys. This is the first time I actually ever mix it up with protein. Now, the protein kind of overpowers the Real Food on this one, but when I take Real Food by itself, so good. I highly, highly recommend it. Try it out, and then let me know in the comments below in the next coming videos what you think. So, gonna finish this, and we'll see you on the next clip. Alright, guys. So, gonna finish out this video with a pretty controversial topic. You know, you hear a lot about this topic everywhere in YouTube, Instagram, bodybuilding industry, fitness industry, and that topic is steroids, guys. And I just want to pretty much give my opinion on steroids and how I feel about them. You know, when I first started my bodybuilding career or my fitness career, lifting career, whatever you want to call it, I was very naive. You know, all the big time bodybuilders that competed in the Olympia and the Arnold and all these major competitions, I always just assumed that they were natural. Again, I didn't, and the reason why I thought it was natural, it was because I figured like big competitions like that drug tested, and it wasn't until, you know, I started gaining knowledge that a lot of these contests aren't, you know, they don't do drug tests, and, you know, blah, 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 and the naive glasses came off, or the naive goggles came off, and I realized, okay, yeah, there is a lot of people out there that are doing steroids, and I know there's a big, you know, big, wide debate on YouTube as far as, like, all the big-time YouTubers, who's natural, who's not, and, you know, you can go round and around and around, and at the end of the day, you honestly don't know. Unless it's someone like ridiculous, like Kai Green, Phil Heath, then you guys like that that are just like, okay, Jay Cutler, like, you know, they were all on gear and all that stuff. My opinion on it is that I don't put anybody down who does steroids. And the one reason why I don't is because that's your life. You know, I never want to sit here and tell people how to live their life. If that's your decision, that's the route you want to go, then do it. You know, I have a favorite YouTuber of mine, Rich Piana, who does steroids, and I, you know, I don't agree with it, but I don't look down on it. I actually think it's pretty interesting and fascinating that, you know, he's one of the only top YouTubers and bodybuilders out there that will admit that he's on steroids, and he doesn't, you know, beat around the bush about it. He flat out tells you what he does, so I respect him for that. Again, I don't have a problem with it. If you say you're natural when you know damn well you're not, like Cali Muscle, I cannot stand Cali Muscle. Like, I just cannot stand him. That's when I have a problem. But as far as, like, you know, if that's what you do, that's what you do, and there's more power to you. I'm not looking down on it. You live the life you want to live. Now, I totally understand it, and the reason why, guys, in this video you saw that I was working out at Gold's Gym. Now, this wasn't the first time I've been there. This gym has been open up for a couple of months now, and I have tried it out. The reason why it took me so long to sign up there is because, man, when I went there, it's not like THRC, like my local gym. I mean, you got dedicated lifters at THRC, but they're, I'm positive 99% of them are all natural. When you go to Gold's Gym, and I totally understand it, I get it, it's Gold's Gym, it's for professionals, it's for people who take it very seriously. In my opinion, there's a lot of people on at that gold that could be on somewhat performance enhancers, you know, whether that's HGH, steroids, testosterone, whatever. And I'm not bashing them. I'm not putting them down. Like I said, I'm sure they work just as hard as you and I, if not harder, in the gym. But the reason why it took me so long to sign up there is because I didn't want to be in that atmosphere, because I can see how addicting and appealing that can get. Like, I'm there at that Gold's and I'm like, dude, like, look at these dudes. Like, I didn't even know these guys lived in my town. I never saw them. I go to gym all over my town and I've never seen these guys. And I'm like, dude, these dudes are ridiculously jacked and huge and shredded. And so I can see how I can easily get sucked into that. I can get... all it takes is a conversation like, hey man, you know, I take this and blah, blah, blah. It leads down a path of that I don't want to be a part of, because it's illegal. So you can't do that. Two, my job, you can't do it. You'll get fired. So yeah, that's what took me so long. But it wasn't, you know, again, it took me a couple months to finally like say, you know what? If it ever gets to that point, I know that I say no, because obviously it's illegal and I can't do that. So that's why, you know, that I can see, I totally get it, man. I understand why young bodybuilders and people around my age are so easily influenced and they get sucked into that industry, because, I mean, they see it all over YouTube. They see it all over Instagram. They see it in the gym. They see these guys that are just look massively huge and ripped and cut, and you're in there in the gym at the same time as them. You know, you're doing as much work as they are, and you feel like you're putting in as much effort as they are, but they're getting these epic results and you're not. And so I can see how it can lead to that. And so that's just my opinion on it. Again, if you do steroids, I have nothing against you. That's your choice. But I definitely understand, man, how it is definitely appealing to these younger generation guys, man. I mean, look at these guys who are just starting into bodybuilding and just getting into the physique world. And they start off on Instagram and they see these guys that are just jacked and just ridiculously shredded that are on performance enhancers. And so that's going to, you know, push them towards that. So it's kind of like you have to make your own decision. Is this something you want to do for the rest of your life? Because it is going to affect you for the rest of your life. Or do you want to commit to be natural and just know that you always did it the right way? It's totally up to you. But that's just my opinion on steroids. I think they're always going to be around. They're everywhere, guys. They're not just in bodybuilding. They're in UFC. They're in the NFL. They're probably in NBA. They could be in. They're in soccer. They're in baseball. I mean, they're probably in hockey. I mean, they're steroids. They're everywhere. They're in the Olympics. I mean, so there is no getting around or getting away from them. They are what they are. And, you know, technology and the people testing them, it seems like the people that are taking steroids are always going to be one step ahead of the people that are testing them, and they can always get away with it. And there's always coming up with different things and different formulas to kind of like bypass the testing. So it is what it is. They're always going to be around. You just have to make the choice whether you want to do it or not. You look at the pros and cons, and you know, sometimes, yeah, it's sad to say that it looks like there's more pros than cons. And that's the truth, man. That's the straight up truth. And again, you have to make that choice. I've made the choice that obviously I want to stay natural. One, because I don't want to get fired. Two, I don't want to go to jail. And three, I just don't think it's worth the headache. Like, you know, it's like, okay, you look good for a couple of months or, you know, whatever, and then your cycle's over. And then you're just like, you're constantly like going down this road. Like, you I don't know, it's just sort of constant roller coaster. Like, you look great, then you look down. Then people start to see you, and they're like, oh, man, he must be off his cycle. Or, you know, oh, he must be on. And it's just like, and then you got to up the dose, like, more and more. It's like, dude, it's just absolute, it just seems like it's an absolute money pit. And it's like a drug. I mean, it is a drug, obviously, but it's something that can just ruin you financially and, you know, maybe physically, health-wise, so. Anyways, that's just my two cents. I would love to hear you guys' opinion on, you know, the whole steroid thing. You know, whether it's just in bodybuilding, Olympics, UFC, all the sports, everywhere. I'd love to hear your opinion on it and what you guys think. And if you did like this video and if you learned anything, give it a thumbs up, guys. I really do appreciate it. It really does help the channel. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and share this video on your Facebook, guys. This is the best way for us YouTubers to get discovered. So that's going to be it. I hope you guys like this video. We will see you tomorrow. Peace. Boom.